This is about health promotion model by Nola J. Pender. Coming to the background of the theorist, Pender, born in 1941 in Mickingham, she got her diploma in nursing from the West Suburban Hospital School of Nursing, and she got her BS in nursing and MA in human growth and development from Mickingham University. And she got a PhD in psychology and education from Northwestern University in 1960. And she has received several awards and honors like American Nurses Association Book of the Year, Distinguished Research Award from Midwest Nursing Research Society, and American Psychological Association Award for Outstanding Contributions to the Nursing and Health Psychology. And she received Mi Etna Doyle Award for Excellence in Teaching from the University of Mickingham. And coming to the health promotion model, this model is an approach or competence-oriented model rather than one that includes fear or threat as a key concept. So that was the first model, and then there were revisions were done, and there were three new variables were added to the model in the revision. That was activity-related affect, commitment to a plan of action, and immediate competing demands and preferences that were added to the model when it was revised. And again, the importance of health, perceived control of health, and cues to action that was deleted from the previous model. And the definition of health, perceived health status, and demographic and biological characteristics were removed and included in a category labeled as personal factors in the revised model. So coming to the theoretical basis of this model, she got the idea of this model from Bandura's social cognitive theory and Feather's expectancy value theory and nursing perspective of holistic human functioning. Coming to the assumptions of this theory, a person seeks to create conditions of living through which they can express their unique human health potential. Person value growth in directions viewed as positive and attempt to achieve a personally acceptable balance between change and stability. Individuals seek to actively regulate their own behavior. Individual in all their biopsychosocial complexity interact with the environment, progressively transforming the environment and being transformed over time. Then, the health professional constitute a part of the interpersonal environment which exerts influence on a person's lifespan. Person have the capacity for reflective self-awareness, including assessment of their own competencies. The next assumption is, she said, self-initiated reconfiguration of person-environment interactive pattern is essential to behavioral changes. Coming to the theoretical propositions by Pender, she says that prior behavior and inherited and acquired characteristics influences the health beliefs, affect, and enactment of health-promoting behavior. Persons commit to engaging in behaviors from which they anticipate deriving personally valued benefits. So when a person values a benefit from a behavior, from a health behavior, they will be engaging in this activity. For example, exercise program. We perceive that exercise program is, we value the exercise program that it is beneficial for our health. So the person usually engaging in that type of behavior. Then perceived barriers can constrain commitment to action, a mediator of behavior as well as actual behavior. So when there is a barrier to a particular behavior, that barrier will obstruct the engagement in that activity. Then perceived competence of self-efficacy to execute a given behavior increases the likelihood of commitment to action and actual performance of the behavior. Then she says greater perceived self-efficacy results in fewer perceived barriers to a specific behavior. Self-efficacy means the ability to do something. That is what self-efficacy. So when there is greater perceived self-efficacy, when we perceive that we have the ability to do something, so the barriers will be very less to a particular health behavior. So positive, she says that positive affect towards a behavior results in greater perceived self-efficacy, which can in turn result in increased positive affect. So our feelings, when we have a positive feeling towards a behavior, that will cause greater perceived self-efficacy, that will help us to have a high level of self-efficacy, which can lead to increased positive affect. The next theoretical proposition is, when positive emotions are associated with a behavior, the probability of commitment and action is increased. Next is, the persons are more likely to commit and engage in health promoting behavior when significant others model the behavior. Just for example, when the mother is doing exercise, the child also imitating her. This is the conceptual framework given by Pender for the health promotion model. There are mainly three concepts: the individual characteristics and experiences, behavior specific cognitions and affect, and the behavioral outcome. So these are the three main concepts of this theory, and there are many variables. We will see the variables in detail. The first one is the concept. First concept is the individual characteristics and experience. In that, the variables are prior related behavior and personal factors. The prior related behavior is influenced by the frequency of similar behavior in the past, and it will influence the direct and indirect effects. It influences or it affects directly or indirectly on the likelihood of engaging a health promoting behavior. And next is the personal factors. They are categorized as biological, psychological and socio-cultural factors, and these factors are predictive of a given behavior and shaped by the nature for the behavior being considered. And we'll see the personal factors in detail. The personal biological factors includes the age, gender, body mass index, pubertal status, aerobic capacity, strength, agility or balance. And the personal psychological factors include self-esteem, self-motivation, personal competence, perceived health status and definitions of health. And the personal socio-cultural factors includes the variables like race, ethnicity, acculturation, then education and socio-economic status. Next is the second concept, that is behavioral specific cognition and affect. In that, there are many variables. The first one is perceived benefits of action. That is the anticipated positive outcome that will occur from health behavior. So, for example, if you are doing exercise, you will be healthy. So, that is a positive outcome. That is an anticipated positive outcome that you will attain when you are doing an exercise. So, that is the perceived benefit of action. Next is perceived barriers to action. So, that is the anticipated, imagined or real blocks and personal cost of understanding a given behavior. So, that can be, for example, to do a exercise program, you may not be having enough time, or you are a working person and you will not get enough time to do a exercise program for the healthy, for your health and for your healthy life. That can be a barrier. Okay, that is a block to do a particular behavior. The next is perceived self-efficacy. Self-efficacy means the ability to do something. So that is a judgment of a personal capability to organize and execute the health promoting behavior. That is what the perceived self-efficacy. Next is the activity related affect. That is a subjective positive or negative feeling that occur before, during and following the behavior based on the stimulus properties of the behavior itself. Next is interpersonal influences. Interpersonal influences are cognition concerning behavior, belief and attitude of the others. These interpersonal influences includes norms, social support and modeling. The primary source of interpersonal influence are the family, peer and the healthcare providers. Next is the situational influences. Situational influences are the personal perception and cognition of any given situation or context that can facilitate or impede a health behavior. The situational influence may have direct or indirect influence on the health behavior. The third concept is the behavioral outcome. In that, there are variables like commitment to plan of action. The concept of intention and identification of a planned strategy leads to implementation of health behavior. Immediate competing demands and preferences. It means competing demands are those alternative behavior over which the individuals have low control because there are environmental contingencies such as work or family care responsibilities. Next is health promoting behavior. The endpoint or action outcome that is directed towards attaining the positive health outcome such as optimal well-being or personal fulfillment and productive living. So this is about the concepts of this health promotion model. Next we will move on to the meta paradigm of the theory. The first one is person. In this theory, person refers to the individual who is the primary focus of the model. And the theory says that each person has unique personal characteristics and experiences that affects the subsequent actions. And the person is recognized that the individuals, the theory recognizes that the individuals learn health behavior within the context of the family and the community. Next is the environment. Here the theory refers the environment to the physical, interpersonal and economic circumstances in which a person lives. The quality of environment depends upon the absence of toxic substances, availability of restorative experiences and accessibility. Next is health. Here in this model, health is viewed as the positive high level state. And according to the theorist, Nola Jepender, she says health means health is defined as a person's definition for himself or herself, which is more important than any other definition of health. So health means it is unique for each individual. Next is nursing. Nursing is does not specifically defined in this theory, but she says the role of nurse includes the rising consciousness related to the health promoting behavior like health education, then promoting self-efficacy and enhancing the benefits of change and controlling the environment to support for the health related behavior. So this is about the meta paradigm of this theory. Thank you.